tell you about the mark of the beast and the Antichrist real quick. Okay, mark of the beast is going to be a global world system that you won't be able to participate in unless you reject Jesus Christ. This system, you won't be able to buy, trade, or sell unless you have the mark of the beast. And then if you don't become a part of it, they'll kill you and your family and all that stuff. So one thing about the mark of the beast is they have this chip called the RFID chip, which is radio frequency ID chip. The Lord identified through his prophets that is the mark of the beast, and you can't accept it. You can't let them implant it in you. Don't let them put it in you as a tattoo. Don't ingest it, and don't let them implant it in your right hand. Like the Bible says in Revelation, it said no man will buy, trade, or sell without the mark. And then they get the mark of the beast in their right hand and in their forehead. That's what the word of God says. And it says that any man that takes the mark of the beast, you're going to come down with these grievous sores. And also, God's not going to let you into heaven, because that's the ultimate form of treason. This RFID chip, it's a GMO, so if you take it, it's going to kill you. Eventually, the chip is going to kill you itself, and so you'll lose your life, and on top of that, you'll lose your soul. So the Antichrist, he's going to be a flesh man that's going to come on the scene, and he's going to be having supernatural powers that he gets from the devil, and he's going to be able to do miracles right in front of you. And so he's going to go into the temple over there in Jerusalem and pretend to be God. And all that stuff like that. So this guy, I mean, when he comes on the scene, he's going to be a smooth talker. Everybody's going to be in love with him, because at first he's going to be uniting all the religions and bringing about world peace and all that stuff. And then the aliens, the UFOs, which are really demons posing as aliens, are going to come down and confirm him. Like, yeah, this is the guy and this is God and we're on God's side and all this bunch of nonsense. Let me tell you how the real God comes back. When Jesus Christ returns back, he ain't doing world peace. He's coming back as a conqueror. And he first thing he does, he burns up his enemies with fire that comes out of his mouth from the word. His word sets people on fire. The word coming from Jesus cuts like a sword and devours up all his enemies. And people that's all underground, those Satanists, they're going to be trying to hide out and all that stuff. And they ain't going to be able to hide out, because they're going to see him coming even through the rock. So he's going to make sure of that. So that's how the real Jesus Christ comes back. He comes back as a God. A God that's putting fire on his enemies. And it won't be no mistakes. But before that, there's going to be false Christ and rising up, like fake Jesus Christ. And then the Satanists and all these enemies are going to be saying, yeah, we got Jesus in the secret place. Come with us and we're going to show you Jesus and all that stuff. It's going to be fake. But the real Jesus, ain't nobody got to go show you the real Jesus. Because when he comes, every eye is going to see him at the same time. So there's no mistake. That's the most grand entrance there is. So don't fall for any of that other stuff. Don't fall for the Antichrist pretending to be God, because he got a little bit of powers that he got from the devil and technology. Because they with Project Bluebeam, they can make holograms of any religious figure that you want to think of just to fool you. So don't fall for any of that stuff. If they tell you you can't eat and we're going to kill your children or we're going to do all this and that, hey, you still can't deny Jesus. You got to hang on to Jesus no matter what, because guess what? Jesus Christ died for us. You know, he took our penalty on the cross. You know, all of us have sinned and was worthy of you know, the ultimate punishment. But Jesus said, hey, I'll take their punishment for them. He said that to the Father. So he took our place on the cross so that we can have a chance to live with God and Jesus in heaven. So we can't wimp out and we can't deny him just so we can eat food or feed our family or save our own lives. You know, that's a coward move. So we can't do that. And if you do that, it's unforgivable. And don't think you're going to take the mark of the beast and then try to cut it off you later on and stuff, because that thing ties into your nervous system. So once you have it, they can pretty much control you. You know what I mean? So if you have it, it's it. It's a wrap. You know what I mean? And then they can control you just like a robot. You won't be able to repent. And if you ain't doing what they said, they can send a signal to that chip and it'll cause you great pain in your body. So do not take the RFID chip. Do not take the mark of the beast. Hang on to Jesus with all you got. And don't fall for no fake Jesuses, no false Jesus. Because Jesus ain't going to come back as no flesh man and be hiding out in some secret place or some flesh Jesus, somebody walking around. No. When the real Jesus Christ come back, he come back as God. And the first thing he's doing is burning up his enemies. He came peaceful the first time. And what did they do to him? They killed him. They murdered him. They were jealous of him. You know what I mean? So this stuff is getting pretty serious. All right? So I'll tell you about the Noahide laws. The Noahide laws put teeth behind the mark of the beast system. Because the Noahide laws came from the Sanhedrin. The Sanhedrin is the same punks that killed Jesus back in his day. Those losers. They murdered Jesus because they was jealous of him. Because Jesus was doing a good thing. He wasn't doing all that fake religion like you see in these fake churches now. That's all Joel Osteen kind of churches. You know, just garbage. You know, just not even preaching the word. Just telling you what you want to hear. Not preaching against sin. Just being losers. So, nah. Jesus came with the real word back then. And they hated him. And all those losers, they killed him. So today, the Sanhedrin came with this thing called the Noahide Laws. The Noahide Laws is a bunch of laws that sound like they make sense at first, but when you dig deep into it, one of the things about it is, if the worship of Jesus Christ to the Noahide Laws is considered idolatry, punishable by death. So that's how they'll be able to threaten you. And all that stuff going to work with this fake religious holy Joe called the Antichrist. When the real Christ comes back, he's going to burn that sucker up. And then all those world powers is trying to fight against Jesus Christ, like he's a bad alien or something, he's going to wipe them out. He's going to mop the floor with them. You know what I mean? So, let's tell you, man, aliens and all that stuff, it's all local. They're not from faraway planets and all that. That's a bunch of garbage. Everything, we are in a closed system. Everything, the planets are all within the Earth. The Earth is the biggest. The Earth is bigger than the sun, the moon, and everything. The Earth is the biggest thing. The Earth is bigger than the planets. Everything, God set up everything around the world, the Earth. Everything is set up around the Earth like a clock. The whole system is a closed system, and it runs like a clock. So ain't no aliens from faraway galaxies coming here and talking about they created us and all this garbage. They're fallen angels, when they had sex with human women, they caused giants to be in the Earth. And when the giants died, their spirits roamed the world as demons. This is what the demons come from. So these little fake alien, light bulb head looking losers with the big black eyes, they're creating them down there in labs, you know, so they can have a body. All that body is an interface for demons, and a demon controls that thing. And then down there in the underground bases, they got species that they're creating, mixing animal and human hybrids, and they're going to bring them out and say, these are aliens from other worlds. They're from other planets and all these junk. And they're making them underground. You know what I mean? They ain't from faraway galaxies. This is to bring that out to fool you. That's why they give you all these movies, Avatar and all this garbage, and all this aliens, light bulb head dudes, stealing people and kidnapping people in the saucers and all that stuff. So, the people that's being taking on the saucers and all that crap, all this anti-gravity craps that we can make. Anyway, when they get taken on the craft and they see that they're going up, they never go into outer space. They always go up and then go down under the water in the ocean, or they go underground. So that's letting you know that whole thing with the aliens is local. It's all local. It ain't far away. None of that. Okay? So just letting you know what time it is, so you won't be fooled and all this stuff like this. So just get ready and just hang on to Christ with all you got. Learn that Bible, because the Word of God has power against demons. You know what I mean? The demons can't do anything without permission. They have to get permission either from you, from your sins, or from God. And the only reason they want you to sin, the demons, is so they can attack you. You know, when you get tattoos on your body, that's an interface. That's an attack point for demons. Demons can't attack. That's why they want you to get tattoos. So you ain't supposed to get tattoos, according to the Word of God. You know what I mean? So all this stuff is knowledge for you. And let all these things that I'm telling you right now, let it be a blessing to you. Let it be seeds that spring up later, so you won't be fooled with some smooth talker giving it. They're going to bring out cures. Let's check this out. They're going to bring out cures and give this Antichrist dude the credit, like he came up with it, or like the fallen angels, or all these aliens, like they came up with it. Listen, it's human beings right now making cures for everything, left and right. And so the Satanists come up, they show up, they give these people money, and then they take these cures and hide them and shelve them. Or they murder the people that won't sell out, you know what I mean? Stuff like that. So it's all a big old plan. It's just a big old plan, and they've been planning it out forever. So it's big battles on right now. The Patriots and the good guys and God's forces against the Satanists. You know what I mean? So that's what's going on right now in the world. So just learn Psalm 91, be able to say it in the face of the enemy. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. Love God with all you got, because he died for you. He gave up everything for you. He was so serious about you, his love for you, that he left his throne. The king left his throne and died for his people just to give you a chance to go to heaven to live with him. What other king done that? What other so-called God did that? None of them. They either want you to kill for them or something like that. But our God died for us. That's big. That's huge. You know what I mean? That's the real deal right there. That's the God I serve. And this God is about love your neighbor as you love yourself. Bless those that curse you. Pray for your enemies. Come on now. Come on now. So that's the real deal right there. It's all about love. If you ain't got love, true love, you ain't got nothing. You know what I mean? And God, you know what he did? He made Adam and Eve. He didn't make Adam and Steve. You know what I mean? So anything that's you're feeling like you want to be a woman and you're a man, or you're a man, you want to be a woman, don't you know that they put stuff in the soil to make you feel that way? Chemicals on purpose. I think it's one's called atrazine, and they spread it on all the crops. And this chemical, it causes male frogs to produce eggs and ovaries and wanna be with other male frogs. And in males, human males, it makes your body produce estrogen. So this is why you're born feeling this way. It was all done on purpose. It was all done on purpose. But guess what? We love y'all. You know what I'm saying? Just letting you know what's going on. So you got to repent. Repent of what you're doing, and just ask God to heal you. And just know what's being done to you. These things are being done to you on purpose. And that's why you're feeling that way. Because the reason that they want to promote that stuff anyway is because they're trying to reduce the population. They want to play God. They think they're God. They don't want to listen to God and his word, the Bible. But they want to play God themselves. See what I mean? They're hypocrites. And they get to decide who lives and dies. They got this stuff, the Georgia Guidestones. They got all this stuff written on the Georgia Guidestones. Oh, we got to keep the population down to less than a billion or whatever it is. So what? They the ones that get to live? Who, how do they get to decide that they are worthy to live and all the rest of us? They look at us as weeds and stuff like that. So look, that's the enemy side. So you got to get with it, get right, get on God's side, get on God's team side. And that's the Jesus Christ team side. Read that King James Bible, baby. Because that's what he gave you instructions on how to make it to heaven. You know what I mean? Follow the four gospels. Christ showed you what to do in the four gospels. You know what I mean? People say, oh, Christianity killed this and that. No, he didn't. Catholics did that back in them days. The Catholics came along and they was killing anybody that wouldn't convert to them. And they were killing us if they caught us reading the Bible. They didn't want us to read the Bible. They wanted us to follow their nonsense and their traditions. You know what I mean? I'm talking about back then, the ones that was killing us. I'm not talking about the Catholics today that believe in Jesus, you know what I mean? Because many of them are going to be in heaven. But you got to know your history and stuff like that. And you got to know what happened. When you follow somebody, you want to call yourself a Christian, you follow somebody, that means you follow the teachings of your leader. Jesus Christ was our leader and our Lord. What did he teach? He didn't teach killing. Him and his disciples, they didn't kill not one person. Not one person, okay? So it says, thou shalt not kill. What that means is, thou shalt not murder. That's what that means. It don't mean thou shalt not kill. It means thou shalt not murder. So self-defense, you know, you have to do what you got to do. You know what I mean? You know, God didn't make you as a doormat. But you got to use common sense. You got to use discernment. And you got to use love. And you got to use mercy. You know what I mean? You're not going to let somebody run up in your house and harm and rape your family. You're going to defend at all costs. You know what I mean? And that's what that means. You know? So just got to use common sense, people, you know, and, you know, y'all have it, just use it, you know, we all got it, we all got gifts, we all got talent, so I just want you guys to know that I love y'all. Don't be offended with me, because I'm telling you this because I love you. If I didn't love you, I wouldn't tell you nothing, you know what I mean, because I don't like all that static and, oh, somebody getting mad because I told them something that's trying to help them. Nah, you know, if I didn't care, I because of that, I wouldn't tell you anything and let you just go ahead on and just worry about myself and just worry about me going to heaven and just say, forget y'all because y'all too hard-headed and y'all fuss back too much. So no, I ain't worried about all that. I'm going to tell you anyway, and that's true love. Well, I'll put up with whatever you throw my way because that's true love, just to tell you the truth, just so you can have a chance in heaven. when you can see me in heaven, shake my hand and say, thank you, Brother Eric. Thank you for telling me that stuff, man. You know, you made me mad at first, but hey, I'm here in heaven right now because what you said planted a seed in me and I thought about it and boom, here I am. Thank you, brother. So that's what I want to see in the end right there. You know what I mean? So don't be getting mad and all that stuff. Just, hey, look at the word, man. You know, listen, the devil controls information, okay? He controls the information. I mean, think about it. Right there in the Bible, it says the devil took Jesus up to a high mountain and showed him all the kings of the world, all the kingdoms of the world, and told Jesus, said, if you bow down and worship me, I'll give you all them kingdoms, okay? So that means that Satan hijacked them kingdoms, and that's how he offered it to Jesus. You know what I mean? Trying to tempt Jesus with those kingdoms that he hijacked. You know, so he controls information. So that's why they're teaching you nonsense in school. Everything they try to teach you in school is against the Bible. Because these enemies, these devils, they want you to die. They want you to go to hell with them. You know, the demons. They already condemned and they just want company. That's what it's all about. Satan just wants company. So that's why everything that's being taught is to go against the Bible. So you won't have a chance. That's what it is. You got to wake up and see what the game is. That's the game right there in a nutshell. Broke it down for you, okay? So that's what's going on, people. Alright? God bless y'all. Hugs and kisses from Jesus and all that good stuff like that. And peace.
Wild Bill, Wild Bill. Watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out. Switch, switch, switch.
Bible prophecy warns of a flesh man coming on the scene with supernatural powers that he got from the devil. Well, he will use these supernatural powers to do miracles in the sight of men, and these miracles he will use to fool the entire world into thinking that he's God or Jesus Christ or try to replace Christ. I'm going to tell you about the mark of the beast and the Antichrist real quick. The Antichrist is going to be somebody that's going to be 100 times worse than Hitler. But when he starts out, he's going to be a beautiful speaker, mesmerizing in appearance, and a man of peace. That's how he's going to present himself. And he's going to unite all the world's religions under him. And he's going to pretty much form a religious dictatorship that will kill anybody that doesn't bow down to him. First on his list will be to kill Christians, to take the place of Jesus Christ, and to claim that he's God. He's going to sit in the temple over in Jerusalem and pretend to be God. Well, his system is going to be financial, economic, and all that. And you won't be able to be a part of that system unless you take an oath to him and reject all your former faiths like Christianity and whatever else you believed in. And if you ain't willing to do that, he'll threaten your family and threaten your kids and threaten your mom to kill them first in front of you and then kill you. But if you're a Christian, you know that you got to stick with Christ no matter what, even if it means death, because Christ died for us. He gave us his all, you know, just so we could have a chance to live with him in heaven. So this mark of the beast and Antichrist, it has teeth behind it, because in 1991, these laws were introduced to the U.S. from the Sanhedrin called the Noahide laws, and it's 7 of them. But as you go deeper into these Noahide laws, one of the tenets is, if you will not renounce Jesus Christ, the penalty is death, because worshiping Jesus Christ to the Sanhedrin and the Noahide laws is considered idolatry. And so they'll murder you. The Sanhedrin is the same guys back in the Bible days that conspired against and murdered Jesus, because they were jealous of Jesus, because Jesus was like an innovator, you know, where they was all about that religion and exploiting people. But Jesus Christ came with the true faith, which was a family-based doctrine, where you have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and Jesus Christ is the Son. He's our Redeemer, he's our Healer, he's our everything. And he came to earth from heaven to show us how to do it. And the difference between him and all these other false gods is Jesus Christ is the only God that said he wasn't too good to die for his servants. So he left his throne in heaven and came down here and died, took our penalty on the cross, because we were sinners and we were worthy of whatever punishment we were supposed to get by the bad things we've done. But Christ said, you know what, Father, I'll take their punishment for them. And if they follow me, I'll lead them to heaven. So leave them in my hands. So Christ is like our lawyer, our defender, our everything, because Satan, all he does is accuse us of all the bad things we do. He's like, hey God, look at what they're doing. They're just like me, so I get to take them into hell. But Christ said, hey, If they follow me, my blood is on them, so they're mine, and I can take them with me to heaven. So that's what the deal is with Jesus Christ and this mark of the beast and Antichrist system. This Antichrist figure, he's going to have supernatural powers and all that. He's going to have everything that he needs from the devil to fool mankind. But just know, if you as a Christian, you can't go along with him just to save your life or to eat or anything like that. Because if you do, God will reject you and you won't be able to go to heaven. So you have to hold on no matter how hard it gets. So it's letting everybody know about the Antichrist and the beast system. All right, guys, make the right choice. God bless you, and I love you.
Yeah, I received an update today on the mark of the beast, and from a prophet of God, and she was telling me about, the Lord was letting her know about the RFID chip, that goes in conjunction with the mark of the beast. Do not take it. Do not let them inject you with it. Do not let them give it to you as a tattoo. And do not ingest it, like taking it, like a tablet, orally. Don't take it at all, because taking the mark of the beast is unforgivable by God. He will not forgive you at all if you take the mark of the beast. And also, that RFID chip, it is a GMO, so once it's in you, it's also gonna kill you, and then on top of that, you lose your soul too, to hell. So have nothing to do with RFID chip. I don't care how much convenience they tell you it's gonna be and all this, just don't take it. Alright people, God bless. I'm gonna read from the book of Revelation, chapter 3, verse 7. And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia, write these things, saith he that is holy, he that is true, he that hath the key of David, he that openeth and no man shutteth, and shutteth and no man openeth. I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it, for thou hast a little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet, and to know that I have loved thee. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world, to try them that dwell upon the earth. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. Him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the name of my God, and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God. And I will write upon him my new name. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. Okay, I'm reading from 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, and this relates to the Antichrist topic. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter, as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he, as God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things? And now ye know what withholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let, until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, and that they all might be damned who believe not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. But we are bound to give thanks always to God for you, brethren, beloved of the Lord, because God hath from the beginning chosen you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit and belief of the truth. Wherefore, whereunto he called you by our gospel to the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brethren, stand fast, hold the traditions which ye have been taught, whether by word or our epistle. Now our Lord Jesus Christ himself, and God, even our Father, which hath loved us and have given us everlasting consolation and good hope through grace, comfort your hearts and establish you in every good word and work.
Stop talking now! First down, Dallas.
Watch, twist! They're going to 53. 26.
The fullback up the middle.
Boom! Yeah,
the tackle
baby.
Made by Patrick Chung. It's a gain of 9. Brings up 2nd and 1 at the 28-yard line.
Here we go. Line 8. Then we're going to 53. Here we go. Going to 54. Going to 54. Line 8.
Don't
take.
Spell.
Kill.
Turn up. Kill. Turn up.
Ezekiel Elliott, the ball carrier.
Let's go.
Stephon Gilmore. It's a gain of 3. And a Cowboy first down.
54. Line 8.
51.
Yeah.
Kill. 26.
Come on now.
Get it. For why?
Check tight.
26.
Let's go.
Pass complete to Blake Jarwin. First and goal, Dallas.
Kill.
Check Joker.
Why?
Get wide.
Check.
And we're going to 54. Wide in.
Check.
Shift.
26.
The fullback up the middle. Devin McCourty on the tackle. A 4-yard gain brings up 2nd and goal at the 5-yard line.
Gun. 26.
Whoa.
Give me the bell.
Touchdown, Dallas.
Kill. 47. 26.
Run.
The 2-point conversion is successful. And makes the score.
He wasn't ready.
36.
He wasn't ready.
Patriots 14. Brady's back.
Mike 50.
Hey, I'm coming after you.
Hey, gold 66.
50 is the mark.
56.
Get him.
Let's go.
A gain of
60. Yeah, let's get a sack first. Alpha. Right to the end.
Brady's pass intended for Josh Gordon.
Wait, that 380.
Mike 50.
Second and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Hey, 66.
Julian Edelman. It's a gain of 14 yards.
Hey, set 53.
Focus, defense.
First down.
Hey, Alabama.
17 yards.
Regular. Let's go.
Josh.
Oh, that's it, baby. That's it. Big hit.
Wait, that's right, Eddie! Right
now, let's go!
You! You!
Alert!
The two-point conversion is successful. That makes the score Cowboys 36, Patriots 22.
Here we go. Here we go. Wide end.
25's the mic.
It's just me and you.
26.
Chris Jones on to punt for the Cowboys.
Come on, baby. Let's go.
Kill.
Let's go. Let's bring it.
Chris Jones on the punt for the Cowboys.
Let's go! Let's go!
Chris Jones on the punt for the Cowboys.
There we go. We're going 24 innings.
We're going 25 the mic. I got it. I got it. Hey, 25 the mic. We're going 20.
We're going 47.
You remember me? You remember me? Let's go, baby. Hey,
26.
We're going 25 the mic.
Watch QB drop. Watch QB drop.
Hey, take your soft shot back to huddle. Soft shot back to huddle.
Hey, here we go. Why they?
Check 55.
Here we go. 46.
Watch the ball. Watch the ball.
46.
a gain of 21 yards. Tony Pollard, the ball carrier.
Not today. There we go. Wide eight.
Going to 54.
Wide
eight. It's a gain of eight. Brings up second and two. At their 40.
Here we go.
A gain of 4 yards. That's another Cowboys first down. First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Here we go. Wide eight.
Mike 5-5.
I know he ain't got it.
Switch it. Hey, what do you think?
Get out of here. A loss of a yard. It's fourth down.
Hey, here we go. Wide in.
There, right there. 54 Mike.
Gun. 26.
Let's go, D-tight. The two-point conversion is successful. That makes the score Cowboys 8, Cowboys nothing. Brett Maher to kick off for Dallas.
Let's go, baby.
On the return, the Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Everyone, wide in.
Check, 48's the mic. I got one.
26.
Ezekiel Elliott, the Cowboy ball carrier.
Nice play, baby,
Byron
nice
Jones
play.
Brought him down. 1 yard gain brings up second and 9 at the 25-yard line.
And watch delay.
Tavon Austin, the ball carrier.
Defense.
Anthony Brown on the tackle.
Let's get it.
A gain of 6 yards. And it's third down.
Here we go. 48.
48th Mike.
Watch the slant. Watch the slant.
Here we go. 47.
Hey, alert 48. Alert. Hey, we're going to mic the 48 right now. Let's go. 46.
Prescott's pass. Intended for Tavon Austin. Incomplete. It's now fourth down.
Forty-eight's the mic.
Watch the screen, watch the screen. Watch the screen, watch the screen. Then we're going to 53.
Check 48's the mic. Ready?
Prescott's pass, intended for Jason Witten.
Come on now, let's go.
It's a turnover on downs.
Hey, kill. Gun. What do you think?
Securing Bravo point. We've lost the lead. You've got 2 more minutes to defeat them. Securing Bravo point. Securing Alpha Point.
Losing Bravo Point.
Not over yet. We are still in this one. Losing Bravo Point. Securing Bravo Point. Losing Bravo Point. We've only got 1 minute left. Securing Bravo Point. Bravo secured. Point.
Watch this. Oh, he gonna remember that.
Decision to bring it out is going to cost. Come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Instead, they got empty backfield as they'll look to throw. And they're going to sack him yet again. The pass rush has been relentless. This time.
48. I got it. Smoke. 48th Mike.
Let's get it. Let's go.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. And going deep for into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And he's gonna.
Gun.
Now a give, right side. Pollard. And he's across for the touchdown. In the final minute, that should just about seal it. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one. Because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change the.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And the return will stop right around the 25. First possession of the third quarter.
Watch the ship. Hey, watch the ship.
On third and long, it's Garoppolo. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Jalen Smith providing a little deja vu, back-to-back sacks, and now they're staring at a fourth and long.